Good morning students. Now today we are going to study the chapter 4th, types of tissues. So here in the previous lectures we already started our chapter 4th, types of tissues. In the previous lecture we studied the first main type of the tissue, that is the meristematic tissue. So after meristematic tissue, now in this lecture we are going to study the permanent tissue. So meristematic tissues are responsible for the growth of the plant. These tissues are also called as the growth tissues because the cells of the meristematic tissues are in a continuous state of cell division. They undergo cell division, they adds new cells in the plant body. So these tissues are called as the meristematic tissue. So growth is possible in the plant because of the meristematic tissue. There are certain characters of the meristematic tissue. These cells are thin-walled, they are isodiametric in shape, the intercellular spaces are absent, vacuoles are not found in the meristematic tissue, so because of which these cells are in a continuous state of cell division. In addition to this, these cells having a dense protoplasm and prominent nucleus. Now from meristematic tissue we are going towards the permanent tissue. So these tissues are developed from the meristematic tissue. They develop and they perform the specific function and forms or develops a permanent structure. So these tissues are called as the permanent tissue. So here one by one we are going to study the different permanent tissue. So there are different permanent tissues. So the permanent tissues are divided into two types, simple tissue and complex tissue. So simple tissues are parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. In addition to this, one more simple tissue, that is the chlorenchyma. It is the collenchyma, but if it is possess the chlorophyll pigment, then such simple tissue it is called as chlorenchyma. The another one type is the complex tissue. So there are two types of complex tissue, xylem and phloem. Xylem, it is made up of tracheids, vessels, xylem sclerenchyma and xylem parenchyma. So all are the different cells from which the tissue has been developed, so it is called as complex tissue. Simple tissue, it is made up of only a single type of cell. Such tissues are simple tissue, for example parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. While complex tissues are made up of more than one type of cell, for example xylem. Another one is the phloem. It is also consist of four different types of cells: sieve elements, that is sieve tubes, sieve cells, companion cells, phloem fibers and phloem parenchyma. So this is the permanent tissues, simple and complex. So in this lecture we are going to study only the simple tissue, that is parenchyma, collenchyma, chlorenchyma and sclerenchyma. Okay, got it? So here we divide different tissues into two main types, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. In the previous lecture we studied the meristematic tissue, where the meristem, which is form of the meristematic tissue. So this meristematic tissue has been divided into different types on the basis of plane of division, origin of the meristematic tissue at the stage of development, okay, and the position of the meristem. These are different types of meristematic tissue. Now here permanent tissue we divide into two types, simple and complex tissue. Further, these complex tissues are divided into two types, xylem and phloem. Okay, now one by one we are going to study the simple tissue. So simple tissues, for example parenchyma. So parenchyma is the one of the most simplest or the primitive tissue. It is the most simple and unspecialized primitive tissue. So this is the diagram of the parenchyma. If you see the shape of the cell, the cells are like the meristematic cells. This is the unspecialized primitive tissue, which is the most simple, that has been developed from the meristematic tissue. It mainly consists of thin-walled cell like the meristematic cells, which have intracellular spaces between them. Here the intracellular spaces are seen in between the cells. Here intracellular spaces are present between the cell. In case of meristematic tissue, there are no intracellular spaces. Intracellular spaces are absent. But it is just derived from, it become just permanent from the meristematic tissue. So it mainly consists of thin walled cells which have intracellular spaces between them. The cell wall, it is made up of cellulose or calcium pectate. Each cell has prominent nucleus and vacuolate cytoplasm. In meristematic tissue, there is no vacuole, or if present, it is small. But here, it is the permanent tissue, that is the parenchyma. So each cell has a prominent nucleus like the meristematic tissue and a vacuolate cytoplasm, which is a different, which is a characteristic of the permanent tissue. Vacuole has been present. The cells are living and perform metabolic processes. There is a large central vacuole in each cell. So here central vacuole has been seen. This is the nucleus of the cell here. So it having a prominent nucleus, but if you see the protoplasm, it possesses the central vacuole. A large central vacuole has been present. The cells are living cells and perform metabolic processes. So parenchyma has been characterized by, it is a most simple and unspecialized primitive tissue. It consists of thin walled cells and have intercellular spaces between them. Cell wall is made up of cellulose or calcium pectate. Each cell has prominent nucleus and a vacuolate or vacuolated cytoplasm. The cells are living and perform metabolic processes. There is a large central vacuole in each cell. So these are the characters of the parenchyma. Now the functions of the parenchyma, it is the fundamental tissue. It provides support, storage, etc. to the plant. Parenchyma is one of type of cells forming the ground tissue and pith in the plant. So these are the functions of the parenchyma. It is fundamental tissue. It provides support. It stored the food material. It is one of the type of cells forming ground tissue and pith in the plants. Okay. Then next to this is the second one, simple tissue, which is polenchyma. So this tissue consists of living elongated cells with corners or intercellular spaces thickened with deposits of cellulose and pectin. Here these are the intercellular spaces which consist of cellulose and pectin. So the cellulose and pectin are deposited in the intercellular spaces present in between the cells. This tissue consists of living elongated cells with corners and intercellular spaces that has been thickened with the deposition of cellulose and pectin. The cells have unequally thickened walls, rectangular, oblique or tapering ends and persistent protoplast. Okay, so this is about the polenchyma. Here the different examples has been given. In case of helianthus, the laminar type of the polenchyma has been seen. Here lamina, these are the layers, one above the other, the layers has been formed of the polenchyma. Here the lacunar type, as in calotropis. Here lacuna, that is the empty space where there is no deposition of the cellulose and pectin, or which is not filled with the deposition of the cellulose and pectin. Lacuna, empty space, that has been seen in between the cells. So the intercellular spaces, there is a deposition of the cellulose and pectin, but it is not completely filled with the deposition of cellulose and pectin. While in case of angular type, as in Leonurus, where these intercellular spaces are completely filled with the deposition of cellulose and pectin. Furthermore, the cell walls consist of cellulose and pectin and have high water content. These cells now becomes permanent, so they have high water content. They are extensible and plastic, so they can extend it having the plasticity. The cells overlap and interlock, forming fiber like strands. In many plants, polenchyma is compact tissue lacking intercellular spaces, and if these intercellular spaces are present, they are filled with the deposition of cellulose and pectin. Sometimes the cells of the parenchyma tissue contain chloroplast and tannins. If the polenchyma tissue contain chloroplast, it is called as chlorenchyma, because they possess the chloroplast and chlorophyll pigments. So this is all about the second one, simple tissue, that is the polenchyma. here the collenchyma, which is thick walled living, which possess the deposition of cellulose and pectin. Intercellular species are present. So in some plant, these intercellular species has been filled with the deposition of the cellulose and pectin. The collenchyma in some plant may occurs in the form of a layers, a single layered. So these layers one above the other, that type is a laminar type of the collenchyma that we found in the Helianthus. Here in case of Calotropis, the intercellular species are empty, so it is called as lacunar empty. Now the third one, here the occurrence of the collenchyma, it occurs in the peripheral region in stems and leaves beneath the epidermis. It present below the epidermis, that is in the hypodermal region. This collenchyma has been seen in the peripheral regions of the stems and leaves, or may be separated from the epidermis by one or more layers of parenchyma. So it is present below the epidermis, but in some plants, here below the epidermis there is a one or more layers of the parenchyma, and below which this collenchyma has been present. In leaves, it is present on one or both sides of the veins and along the margins of the leaf bed. So they are present at the margins, on the sides of the leaf blade. Collenchyma may occur in cortex of the roots, in peripheral regions if roots are exposed to the light. So cortex of the root, it is collenchymatous, it is made up, it is occur in the cortex of the root. It present one or both sides of the veins and along the margins of the leaf blade. So this is the occurrence of the collenchyma. Now the functions of the collenchyma. The main function of the collenchyma is give the mechanical support. So it is a mechanical tissue which gives mechanical support to the growing plant organs. Collenchyma tissue gives considerable tensile strength with flexibility and plasticity to the organs like roots and stem. So it possesses the high water content, because of which the cells are flexible, having plasticity. So it gives the tensile strength to the plant organs like root and stem with flexibility and plasticity to the organs. Plasticity of the collenchyma changes with the age. When it is chlorenchymatous, it performs the function of photosynthesis. When collenchyma consists of chloroplast, chlorophyll pigments, then we call it as chlorenchyma. So when this collenchyma is chlorenchymatous, it performs the function of photosynthesis, because we know that the involvement of the chlorophyll pigment in the process of photosynthesis, so that plant can synthesize their own food material. So this is all about the collenchyma. Next simple tissue is the chlorenchyma. So this is the third one, simple tissue, chlorenchyma. Here it possesses the chloroplast. When parenchyma cells are exposed to light, they develop chloroplast in them. Such tissue is known as chlorenchyma. So chlorenchyma, it is the parenchyma. When it is made up of parenchyma cells, it is made up of thin walled cells. When parenchyma cells are exposed to the light, they develop the chloroplast in them. They perform the photosynthesis. Such tissue is known as chlorenchyma. The chlorenchyma possesses well developed aerating system. Intercellular species are abundant in the photosynthetic parenchyma, that is the chlorenchyma of stems too. So this is about the chlorenchyma, which perform the process of photosynthesis, because these parenchyma cells, when exposed to the light, they develop the chloroplast in them. Such tissues are known as the chlorenchyma. So it possesses the well developed aerating system. Intercellular species are abundant in the photosynthetic region of the stem, that possesses the chlorenchyma. So here in this diagram we can see the chloroplast on the inner wall of the parenchyma cell. So these cells perform the process of photosynthesis. Similarly, this is the palisade parenchyma, this one is the spongy parenchyma, where the intercellular species we can clearly see. So here also the chloroplast has been present in the parenchyma cells. So such cells are called as chlorenchyma. Okay, now the fourth one, simple tissue, it is the sclerenchyma. Now we go towards the complexity of the tissue, from simple towards the complex, because after sclerenchyma we will start the complex tissue. So this sclerenchyma is in between the simple tissue and the complex tissue. It looks like a complex. The sclerenchyma tissue is a complex of thick walled cells whose principal function is to give mechanical strength to the plant organs. So main function of the coelenchyma and sclerenchyma, it gives the mechanical support, it gives the mechanical strength to the plant organ like root, stem. So the sclerenchyma tissue is a complex of thick walled cells. It consists of thick walled and lignified dead cells. So the cells are dead. In case of coelenchyma, the cells are living. In chlorenchyma also, the cells are living. In parenchyma, cells are living. But the sclerenchyma cells are thick walled, lignified dead cells. It is composed of very long, narrow cells known as fibers. So fibers are thread like structures that makes the sclerenchyma. So in this diagram here, we can clearly see these are the sclerenchyma cells which are having a thick wall, having a large central vacuole. These cells are lignified dead cells, while some of the sclerenchyma cells possess a very long narrow cells known as the fibers. So these are the fibers, thread like cells, while relatively short cells are known as the sclerites. So here these structures where we can see the sclerites, which are relatively short cell, while fibers are very long narrow cells. So these are the narrow long cells, we call it as the fibers, while sclerites are relatively short cell. The cells possesses lignified secondary cell wall and do not possess living protoplasm at maturity. So the cells of the sclerenchyma, both fibers and sclerites, they possesses lignified secondary cell wall and do not possess living protoplasm at maturity. Sclerites are thick walled dead cells. These are short cells of various shapes, roughly classified as brachysclerites. So brachysclerite, also known as stone cell, because if you see the shape of this cell, it looks like a stone which is highly lignified. They are short, roughly isodiametric. If you see the shape of these cells, the shape is isodiametric. Brachysclerite, these cells are also called as stone cell, where it shows the deposition of the lignin. The cells are thick walled. These are the dead cells having a various shapes. They looks like a stone. So these cells are also known as stone cells. Next is the macrosclerites. So macro, these are elongated rod like cells forming the palisade like epidermal layer. So these are rod like. Okay, here the shape, it is rod like. So these cells are called as macrosclerites. So they are elongated rod like cells forming the palisade like epidermal layer. So palisade tissue, which is present below the epidermis in case of leaf, it possesses macrosclerites. That is the type of sclerite, that is the cells of sclerenchyma. We know the sclerites, these are the short thick walled cells, while fibers are very long, narrow, elongated cells. So macrosclerite, it is one of the type of sclerite where the cells are elongated rod like, that we've seen in the palisade tissue, macrosclerites. Then osteosclerites. Osteo, so it is concerned with the bone. So the cells are bone shape. Here we can see this bone shape cells, that is columnar cells enlarged at the ends. Astrosclerites. Astronaut, so it is concerned with the star shaped cells, ramified to varied degrees. So here we can see the astrosclerites, which are star shaped. Some more types: filiform sclerites, long slender slits resembling fibers. So these cells are looks like a fiber, because we know that the sclerites are short cells. Okay, the fibers are very long cells. So these filiform sclerites are long slender cells resembling fibers. Trichosclerites, these are branched thin walled sclerites resembling plant hair. So the name give is a trichome. These are the outgrowths or the hairs that are seen on the leaf stem. So they are branched thin walled sclerites resembling the plant hairs. So the name given to such type of sclerites, these are trichosclerites. So these are different types of sclerites. Now we are going for the fibers. So fibers are very long, narrow, थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स. सो फाइबर्स आर लिग्निफाइड और नॉन लिग्निफाइड इलांगेटेड सेल्स. सो हियर वी कैन सी दीज आर द इलांगेटेड लॉन्ग सेल्स. फाइबर्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नेचर एंड ऑकरेंस इन द फॉलोइंग टाइप्स. झाइलरी फाइबर्स, सो दोज फाइबर्स विच ऑकर्स इन द वुड रीजन ऑफ द पार्ट, सो दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज वुड फाइबर्स. एक्स्ट्रा झाइलरी, आउटसाइड ऑफ द झाइलम, दीज आर द बास्ट फाइबर्स. फ्लोएम फाइबर्स, कॉर्टिकल फाइबर्स, पेरीवास्कुलर फाइबर. सो दीज फाइबर्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नेचर एंड इट्स ऑकरेंस. झाइलरी, इट ऑकर्स इन द झाइलम, सो इट इज वुड फाइबर्स और झाइलरी फाइबर्स. एक्स्ट्रा झाइलरी, आउटसाइड ऑफ द झाइलम, बास्ट फाइबर्स. इन द फ्लोएम, फ्लोएम फाइबर्स. इन द कॉर्टेक्स, कॉर्टिकल फाइबर्स. पेरीवास्कुलर फाइबर्स, इन बिटवीन द वास्कुलर बंडल, इट इज पेरीवास्कुलर फाइबर्स. फाइबर्स मे बी सेप्टेट और नॉन सेप्टेट. हियर द पार्टीशंस मे बी सीन, दैट इज द सेप्टेट, इट इज और नॉन सेप्टेट. फाइबर्स डिफर्स फ्रॉम स्क्लेराइड्स इन द फॉलोइंग रिस्पेक्ट. एज यू नो दैट द फाइबर्स आर लॉन्ग सेल्स विथ पॉइंटेड एंड्स, स्क्लेराइड्स आर शॉर्ट टू कॉन्स्पिक्यूअस, सेप्टेट और नॉन सेप्टेट इलांगेटेड. पिटिंग इज नॉट कॉन्स्पिक्यूअस इन द वॉल्स, पिटिंग इज कॉन्स्पिक्यूअस इन द वॉल्स. फाइबर्स अराइज फ्रॉम मेरिस्टेमेटिक सेल्स, स्क्लेराइड्स अराइज थ्रू सेकेंडरी स्क्लेरोसिस ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स. सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन फाइबर्स एंड स्क्लेराइड्स. फाइबर्स आर लॉन्ग सेल्स विथ पॉइंटेड एंड्स, स्क्लेराइड्स आर शॉर्ट सेल. पिटिंग इज नॉट कॉन्स्पिक्यूअस हियर इन स्क्लेराइड्स, पिटिंग इज कॉन्स्पिक्यूअस इन द वॉल्स. फाइबर्स अराइज फ्रॉम मेरिस्टेमेटिक सेल्स, डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द मेरिस्टेमेटिक सेल्स, स्क्लेराइड्स अराइज फ्रॉम द सेकेंडरी स्क्लेरोसिस ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स. Now the sclerenchyma occurrence. So sclerenchyma occurs as a mechanical tissue along the conducting strands and in the cortex of stem, root, fruit, seed coverings of the vascular plant. So this is the occurrence or the location of the sclerenchyma, where it occurs as a mechanical tissue along the conducting strands, conducting strand, that is the xylem and phloem, in the cortex of stem, root, fruit and seed coverings of the vascular plants. Fibers occurs as septate strands in the cortex and the phloem as a sheath or bundle caps associated with the vascular bundles or in groups or scattered in the xylem and phloem. So fibers that occurs as a separate strand in the cortex, in the phloem as a sheath or a covering or bundle caps, these are the cap like structures, occurs above the vascular bundle, it is associated with the vascular bundle. They occur in groups or scattered in the xylem and phloem. For example, in maize, sugarcane, cucurbita, as bundle sheath in hypodermis, as long fibers. So if we see the bundle sheath cell, bundle sheath, so a covering that occur on the vascular bundle in case of monocots such as maize, sugarcane, while in cucurbita here seen as a bundle sheath or vascular bundle covering in hypodermis as long fibers, in linum, nerium as the peripheral fibers, in nicotiana, clematis, vitis as the fibers in secondary phloem, form after secondary growth, secondary phloem, in agave as extra xylary cortical fibers. So this is the occurrence of the sclerenchyma in the different parts of the plant organs. Occur in the cortex and the pith of gymnosperms, dicotyledons, arranged singly or in groups in xylem, phloem, they remain integrated with the fibers. So this is the occurrence of the scleroid. These are the short cells, thick walled cells, which occur in the cortex in the pith of gymnosperm and dicotyledons plants, arranged singly or in groups in xylem and phloem, they remain integrated with the fibers. Scleroids are common in fruits and seeds, present in the form of solid layer forming hard covering or stony endocarp. So scleroids, it forms the fruit covering that we also called as a pericarp. So pericarp has been divided into epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. So it forms the solid layer in the fruit and seed forming hard covering or stony endocarp. For example, leguminous seed coat, stony endocarp of mango, coconut, coverings of nuts, so all these are made up of the scleroids. Now the functions of the scleroids. This is a supporting tissue which withstand various strains, which results from stretching and bending of plant organs without any damage to thin walled cells. So it gives elasticity to the plant organ. It is provide the mechanical support. It is the supporting tissue which withstand various strains that has been resulted from stretching and bending of the plant organ without any damage to thin walled cells. Fibers provide strength and rigidity to the various organs of the plants. Scleroids form hard protective covering on fruits and seeds. So the main function of the sclerenchyma is to provide the mechanical support so that the plant can withstand against various strains that are caused due to the stretching and bending of the plant organ. Individually, as you know, that sclerenchyma that is made up of short cells, short thick walled cells, scleroids, and the very long narrow elongated cells which called fibers. So both scleroids and fibers that gives the strength and rigidity to the plant organ. More precisely, scleroids form hard protective covering on fruit and seeds, while fibers provide strength and rigidity to the various organs of the plant. So this is all about the simple tissue. So simple tissue which belong to the permanent tissue. So parenchyma, colenchyma, chlorenchyma and sclerenchyma, these are the simple tissues which are permanent tissue found in the different part of the plant or in the different plant organ, which gives the mechanical support, while the parenchyma, which function as a ground tissue, which store the food material, which makes the ground tissue of the plant. So this is all about the permanent tissue, of which only we studied simple tissue, that is parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma and chlorenchyma. In the next lecture we will study the complex tissue, both xylem and phloem. So this is all for today. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.